there, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode here on Pastiche of Skin. It's good to see you again. Thank you very much for coming back to the channel. We're still working our way through the PlayStation Plus titles for the month of February in 2017. And today we're looking at Little Big Planet 3. Now, Little Big Planet is a Media Molecule series that actually has been a massive selling title for Sony since the release of the PS3. And I've never really gotten into Little Big Planet. I played a little bit of Little Big Planet kart racing because it was a kind of a fun multiplayer game to play. But the actual individual games, I think I've actually probably played maybe like one or two levels at any point of any of the Little Big Planet games. And they've grown from what they were with just their regular little Sackboy on his own to actually having a whole family of characters that he parties together with. Now, I don't disparage the game in any shape or form. It looks like a fun platformer, but Media Molecule kind of got my attention because of their soon-to-be-released Dream game, or it's actually a game-building game that's actually got a very, very... It looks like it's a kind of a game that you can literally build games in VR because you're kind of like in the world, manipulating all the bits and pieces around it.
One can gaze upon something and see the wonder in it.
Two can gaze together and share that wonder. I'll always love the narration of these games. They're actually they're well put together. They're actually well done. There's an idea behind it that there's actually like a creative spark in absolutely everyone. And I tried to sit down and play a little bit of this with a niece of mine's. She would be of the age of the character of people that they showed at the beginning of that video, and she was like watching this, going, "I don't get it," and I'm like, "This." This whole idea, this whole overly explanation kind of like world of Little Big Planet is designed for an adult. It's not, it's like an adult's attempt at childhood wonder, and that's probably fine. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. Let's just skip that and get out of the way.
You're back, and precisely.
Problem occurred when attempting to connect to the PSN. Oh, that's not good.
Rival signifies the ground.
Right. So that means I can't do any community stuff actually here on the.
Everything.
That's really disappointing, actually. Okay, well, we'll jump into actually the pre-made levels and have a wee look at that. Because essentially, I will look at some adventure, and after I finish the adventure-y part, I might actually just jump into the community and see a couple of test games. Because I've seen people chatting about like the homemade crate levels being really interesting. Hopefully, if I log out of this and log back in again and reconnect, I don't know why I'm actually being pulled off of the PlayStation Network. It might be down at the moment. There hasn't been any problems throughout the day so far, so it might be, it's just weird that it's actually happening now. Getting stuff ready for things. Well, okay. Check the date here as well. I'm wondering if there's actually a scheduled maintenance at this time whenever I'm recording this.
Yourself. A cuddly... A sack person.
Sack boy!
What a cracker!
Okay.
Use the left stick to move your sack person.
Yeah, I figured that.
Tippy tappy.
Sumo Digital? So, is Little Big Planet 3 not done by the original creators? Let's tell me to go this way. Okay. Moving things.
Take a run and jump, why don't you?
So it's actually teaching me basic mechanics.
A quick tap for hippity hop and a long press. Transporting oneself from the
Oh yay, making ourselves look pretty and cute.
Is akin to being born again.
Hey, that's kind of adorable. Alright, let's move on. Runny, 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 run. Tarsier Studios station. So it appears that it's all, it seems to be like a bunch of names of companies that actually, am I making a complete mistake here? Aye. Special thanks to Media Molecule. So is Little Big Planet actually a Media Molecule game anymore? Fair enough. I suppose once you build the world, the concept, and then let somebody else kind of take it over. I mean, essentially it's a series of art tools, really more than anything else.
Yes. Thanks for that, old man. I'll take it from here. Oh, what luck. There's my little chum-to-be, ready to come and help me sort out Bunker. Just a simple press of this button, and our adventure will begin.
Oh,
No. So, the one on the left. Come in. If I'm facing it, then that would be. Look. That's the one.
Okay. So there actually is like a proper story to this one, rather than actually being kind of like a little bit of fun and game. Interesting. Grab on to something, kiddo. Tag boy, grab on! No! So Little Big Planet 3, essentially, I mean, transport to another place to help somebody do something, which seems to be done by the actor that played Gregory House, Hugh Laurie. I could not think off the top of my head what his name was. I think I remember actually seeing like interviews with Hugh Laurie back whenever this game came out, where he was chatting about doing the voice acting for this, and he's got a wonderfully charming voice, and especially with the fact that Stephen Fry used to do the narration for this, or was that even Stephen Fry that's still doing the narration for this? Because I've been talking over the top of it. It's just very welcoming. It's very welcoming and homely feeling, especially like, to go from one to the other. If like essentially retired one voice to move on to somebody else, he might as well move on to his lifelong entertainment partner. And longtime friend. Well, obviously we're gonna get launched out of here. Whoop! There we go. Well, isn't that adorable?
It worked! You're here! Sorry for the rough ride, old chap. My name's Newton.
As in Sir Isaac Newton?
Chummy chum chum, where the sky is strewn with circling clouds of imagination, all ceaselessly pumped into Buncombe's atmosphere by the pounding creative heart at its core.
The human mind.
But, I'm afraid, Buncombe's destiny lies in our hands. Let me explain.
Okie dokie.
The former negativitron nearly laid waste a craft world. Three gluttonous gargoyles gorged on Buncombe's bountiful creativity. Inspiration dried up. We teetered on the brink of the abyss. And then three heroes came. With their speed, with their power,
with
their grace.
So Bird Buddy, Big Buddy, and Dog Buddy.
They finally managed to capture the Titans.
And put them in small tin box.
Restored to the creative paradise you see around you, the heroes retire to the pages of myth.
And now you must find them again.
Also foretells of the return of the Titans.
Oh no!
Tonight, just before bedtime, all of Buncombe's nightmares become real. And that's where we come in.
We are the heroes.
My noble assistant, Buncombe's very future depends on we two brave heroes.
I love the fact that it's actually like, it's built in the game. So like all the gesticulation and movement and stuff is all kind of things you can properly put in. Like, my flappy head. So I'm willing to bet you actually can get his body type to actually like replace it as a skin over the top of your own sack boy, which is fair enough. Ironing out the creases, it's like fold away, or is it not fold away, tear away, unfolded. The entire idea that everything is crafted. Jeez, okay. Wow, he's massive actually. I just realized that.
I love the mountain air, it's just so airy.
Stickers, all the stickers. Get all the stickers
to move in and out of the screen.
Just getting all the stickers, all the sticky things.
Press the action button to jump down a step.
All right, so that's it. Essentially to show us that we can move through multiple planes of existence, essentially. We're no longer in a two-dimensional world. We're in a 2.3-dimensional world. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Did I ever tell you about the time I got stuck in a hat? I did? Well, it's a true story and still relevant today, as the danger of getting stuck in Little Big Planet is as real as it ever was. If you find yourself impassable crevice or an insurmountable rut, your poppet holds the key to your salvation. Open it with your menu button and highlight the retry option using your left stick. Then simply hold the action button until your little stitched chum pops
himself. Right, there we go.
Layer launchers spring you from front to back and back to pet it. Bounce in and out bouncing in and out thing.
Alright, so if I jump up here, nope, that's not right. So if I bounce. I get that. If I bounce that way, I get that one. Bouncy. Bouncy. Whee!
Excellent work. Your bounding knows no bounds.
Boundless.
To trigger blue layer launchers.
All right.
To climb along a climbable surface.
Ah.
You can still jump while you're climbing. Just press the action button.
Why would you ever want to not be climbing? Anytime you're actually going to be near a climbing surface. Whoop, there we go. Way. There we go. Up we go.
Wonderful work. I knew you could do it.
There's no more here, is there? No. So wonderfully creative.
Good work. Let's go.
Why can't I just jump into the back with you? You son of a bitch. Let's see. I'll let this actually launch me. That makes sense.
Use the grab button to take hold of spongy bits and the left stick to drag them about.
There we go.
Tap the action button while dragging or pushing to give yourself a little oomph.
I can't jump and pull things into the background, can I? No. Ah, right, now I got it. I need to grab this and come across with it. Jumpy. Thank you. And over here with you. Up you get. Didn't mean to pull you away. Up you get. Ah. Up you get, and there we go.
Oh, yes, good work. We are amazing.
Damn it, I missed that. Nah, I'm not gonna get that sticker.
Grab that old dangly thing and use the left stick to swing across.
Ha!
Jolly useful, eh?
Hey! Hey! Whoop! Oh! No! Ah, I missed all of them. Damn it. Easily jumped across. Oh, wait, hang on. Whoop! Yeep. Hang on, we need enough momentum. Yeah! Nice, got it. Get all of them. Whoa. Beep. Alright, so I've been captured.
We must retire to my airship to prepare for your, our death-defying mission.
I feel like I've covered all the basic bases there. So, Don Newton does seem to be kind of like almost a villainous character. I don't know. He's got the standard rules of actually villainy. It's he has his own airship. He's obviously had power at the beginning, and he needs your help, so he's going to make use of you. I don't trust him. I don't trust him at all. Oh, yes. And then extra bits that you get for doing that. Putting the cat back in the bag. You know, it's actually extremely difficult. Just hurting cats in general, not worth your time. By daunting jump, be sure to get a running start. Well, to be honest, there never is a sense of peril in Little Big Planet. It's just like, you'll get through this if you can just find what thing to grab.
Of course, but I made some refinements of my own.
Okay.
Look at us! Co-conspirators! Primed for our first top-secret mission briefing. Here, take this sticker.
Okay.
Is our first target. A loathsome locale called Stitcher Manor. Stick it up on the mission board.
In the real world, slapping stickers on anything and everything is frowned upon. Rightly so. Have you ever tried peeling a sticker off
within
a
those walls? Soon, lurks a cranky old bag named Nana Pud. Put her face up there if you can stomach it.
Right, so essentially just encouraging us to make stickers and put them up, and because otherwise, like, I in real life, I absolutely abhor stickers. I can't stand them.
Brave her horrors and make our way up onto the roof.
What? And this is what we need. Oh, what did I do? There we go. And that one. There we go.
The tin that houses the evil titans.
Yeah, I don't trust anything that actually is, like, holding the titans into your possession, chap. I just don't trust you.
Something for just this occasion. Going down.
Keep.
Imagination made mechanical. Handheld inspiration. It sucks. It blows. It is the Pumpinator.
Yeah, baby. Needs a pump. I guess it's broken.
Working yesterday.
Well, sorry. Okay, is this a new tool?
Now, just pick it up, and I can show you how useful it is.
You can't have too many pockets. This is precisely why I want to introduce you to the all-new sack pocket. Press right to bring up the sack pocket. Use your left stick to highlight the particular thing you wish to pull out of the sack pocket.
Such an amazing device. Oh, if only Daddy were here to witness it. You can aim it in different directions using the right stick. Point it at that pinwheel and press the R1 button to blow it into motion.
Right, so you actually have mechanics to keep things rolling now. That makes cool. That you can interact with your environment better.
Try giving those boxes a blow.
Ooh, come back here.
Marvelous, isn't it? Ooh, that platform is broken. Press the L1 button to suck it in.
Ah, I get you now. I understand what its function is a pull and push things into your position then. God damn it. That's kind of cool. It's a good way to get grab bubbles.
The scholars of the omniverse have forever debated what the most satisfying feelings in existence are. They used to say,
"Hurry up, dear chum!"
Now they used to say, "Hurry up, dear chum!" Boingy. Oh, that's cool. It's a that's how you actually use it to make use to get into positions?
Two like that, it means you need to bring a friend. Actually, you can bring up to three friends if you like. The more the merrier.
Alright, so I need both two people to do that one. Makes sense.
Here we are. Activate those switches and we'll be on our way.
Boom, one goes. And one goes there.
Brilliant. Join me in this super vertical infiltration station.
Super vertical infiltration station? I.e. just jump into. Oh, there we go. Get across there. And there's that and that I wanted. I get that. That's kind of cool. And down we go. Whee!
Jamana, we go!
Rocket down. 3, 2, 1. There you go. Extra bonus stickers all over the shop. So, yeah, I might actually drop out of this story mode now and take a look at some of the community stuff. This obviously is very, very well put together. The main campaign for Little Big Planet never held my attention beforehand, but it seems it has like a narrative kind of arc to this one now, so that it feels like there's actually like a full involved story that doesn't involve the community designs.
Not a great victory for health and safety, but
it's... but success for our travel anyway.
This old chum.
Old chum.
Manor. The final resting place of those dreaded titans.
I don't like this.
The crazy crone who lives here, I suspect to be the prophetic liberator of those diabolical denizens.
Aw, oh, poor little old granny.
You must get up there and stop her.
But I...
Well, I've got eggs to boil.
Huh?
But rest assured, I'll be right behind you. Well, right behind you. Give you a bit of space, obviously. But safely.
Yeah, you're a bit of a shithead, aren't you? Huh. Oh well. Time to save the world once again. Alright, so it's stirring the pot, it's bagging the cats, it's ironing the wrinkles, it's doing all the things. A friend or three, some secrets can't be found on your own. So that's the reason why you have to unlock the other three characters, which I imagine after you unlock the Titans, bring them back to the fore. So yeah, obviously this looked cute and adorable and had a whole pile of stuff to see. Can I get out of that? Yes, I can. Nope. There we go. Hey! Alright, I'm not meant to have gone in there, am I? Whoops. Either way, we're going to be jumping out of this anyway and go back to the main menu. Turn the map. Yay! The Whosits? But what about the Whatsits? I'm sure it didn't even worry about the Whatsits. The Whatsits are already bagged. I'm just checking my schedule here. See it? Obviously, you've got an idea of what this world is like. Essentially, it is going to be a linear adventure that you've got to play. Even then, like, whenever I do that, it's like, that is just the default one, isn't it? Yeah, the prologue. There's plenty more where that comes from. Puzzles, more stories, what's that? Purchase a new adventure? She's not letting me. To use this function, you have to connect to the internet. Yeah, so I'm assuming there was actually a reason why the network, maybe the PSN network was down for maintenance or something. That's what I imagine it was. Because there is... Hi.
We've all
there we go. That's why, like, I was wondering what was going on there.
Shop. But when we get home and put them on, they look ridiculous. Thankfully, up here we have the Little Big Planet changing room facility. You can try on every available sack person's costume and observe what you look like in it.
All right. So this is actually for all the DLC stuff that you would have pulled down from different games. Okay, I get you. So it actually integrates the PlayStation Store in, because there we go, because I mean, essentially it's all the bits and pieces have been thrown into this over time. I mean, this is the reason why a game like this gets given for free. It's to encourage you to buy all these level kits and stuff. Caribbean, Monsters, Little Big Planet 2, what's that, Movie Kit? Or Move Pack? Alright, Muppets, Night Before Christmas, DC Comics, Adventure Time, Tiki Paradise, SpongeBob SquarePants, Back to the Future, Journey Home. So, oh, wait, the Journey Home, is that actually the... It actually is a continuation of this. Huh. Fair enough. So there actually is like a DLC expansion packs for the Legend in the World. But we need to take a look at community. Because these are where this is what Little Big Planet really is all about. Team picks. Legendary Vampire. Ooh, level of the day. Well, let's take a wee look at the level of the day and we'll give that a try. I think that's probably our best bet. And we'll play the Legend of the Day. There are other sack folk playing on this level. Would you like to join their game? Might as well join them. Why not? Because there's other people playing on it. Might as well jump in on it.
Okay, so you're now free from the confines of your podcast.
Ah, bugger. But disconnected.
Get the vibe of the place. You might want to invite some chumblies over. Now, should you wish...
Join? I'm going to try that a couple of times to see.
Of authorities that standing before it.
I think I might have been thrown into a round just as somebody else was dropping out.
First.
People anonymous left their second. I'll just play on my own and then somebody else is welcome to join me if they want to. Tracing over everything in band. I mean, that's kind of like the standard thing you have to do. Well, I'll just sketch it in. We'll get it partially there. Oh, smart. Alright, I get you. So don't be in the rain whenever. Ow. What was that? Ah, I get the thing. Wait, what? What's going on here? So I'm meant to glide like that. And that's that. But if I... Right! Oh, and I have to... okay, I gotcha. I'm wondering why I was actually kept on getting killed there, because I have to re-mist myself as I'm actually like coming back up again. I get it. So that's why these levels, community made, tend to assume a level of actual like skill, I imagine. There we go. So we jump down, and we go like that, and we go like that, and then we're back again. Boom, sorted. And we jump across. Oh, so you have to actually make it through the level. Oh, I get you now. Interesting. I like the fact that it's actually, like, this is properly challenging, and you'd fall into another bit if you didn't actually. You have to time your miss changes very well. Oh. Oh. Well, I might as well just do this. Is that it? Oh, that was actually removed that, and then I have updrafts. I getcha. Kind of cool. Whoa! Nicely done. Whoa! Ah! It really is about memorization on some of these levels. Oh, are you kidding me? Right. Thank you. So, God damn it. Yeah, extra bonuses. Woo! Alright. There we go. What happened? Ah! Fell down there. Damn it. Let's try that again. Yay, new sticker! Alright, and down we go. Ah! I know what happened. I actually got dissipated by the now I figured it out. It was the rain that actually killed me whenever I went around the corner. Alright. Oh! What is this?
I became the bat.
All right. Yeah, that was grand. I messed that up. One, two. All right, so I need to actually use that to boost my little bat jump. Ah! You can only do it for so long. All right, I think I figured that out. So up I get, and if I go up that way, and then I jump across, and then I use that to get myself across. I need to actually then do it in the opposite direction to get up, up, and there we go. And then I get up that way, and there we go. Can't see where I'm going. All right, there we go. Right, okay. That one was a little bit distracting because I need to actually do... Okay, and then whenever I go up here, I have to... up that bit. Oh, there we go. And then I'd actually jump across like that. Alright, gotcha. I think I got this. Nope, I don't got this. I don't got this. Okay. I thought that was what I was sent you meant to do. No? Okay, am I meant to actually, like, jump in the back of that? This is weird. Not too sure how I'm actually meant to be doing this. So, up I get. Yeah, okay, so I need to actually use the bounce to knock me from one to the other. I don't know how I'm actually meant to get into... Bouncy bounce? Oh, right. This is actually grapple and carry along. I was wondering why I was actually, like, holding up there. So, if I jump and go across like that, that should work. And if I... Oh! Damn it. Right, I knew what I was meant to be doing there that time. I've got this. I've got this, man. So, I need to jump up. And up I go with my jumpy bits. And then cast through. Yep. Bounce across. Bouncy up. Oh, I fell in the water. I fell in the water. I fell in that water. Alright, I got this. I got this. I got this. Woo! Bounce through. Whoa. Ah, man. That was just me making a mistake of actually jumping too far that time. Getting too zealous. I got this, man. I've got this down pat now. There we go. Jump across. Oh, man. I need to use... I don't want to lose momentum whenever I crawl across there, because I said I got stuck in the wall. There we go. Let's see. Boom. Boom. 23. Yep. There we go. So, jump. I need to remember to immediately stop it, because if I continue on, I'll go through into the rain. Alright, I gotcha. That's where I made that mistake that time. Won't let that happen again. Go. Boom. So, jump across. And immediately on gas. Yeah. Boom! Made it. Oh, shit! Don't... Oh, I was so worried there. I thought I was going to be sent back even further. Oh. Ow. Ow. Okay, there may be another way to... Let's see, I can't... Damn it, now that's actually made it worse. Ow. Right, now I get that one. Ow. Ow! Messed that up. Really? Really? Stop doing that! Wow, you really do, like, you have to actually be, like, precision timing on some of this. God damn it. Yep, I messed that up. I didn't mean to jump across there. Nope! Ah. There's no way I was actually... I gave myself too much momentum going one direction there. Let's see. Bam. There we go. Yeah. Alright, managed to make it across. Right, and we drop down here. Hey! Right. Oh, man. I made it through the level at least. I knew it was almost done. It couldn't have been that far back. Yeah, 229th. That's not bad. That's not bad. That's okay. That's okay. I'm okay with that. For a daily challenge level, I'm okay with that. So yeah, that's, wasn't too bad. I mean, essentially that's how these levels are done. They're just, greatest hits, best levels, most hearted, one of the people's favorites. Honor the Fallen King, multiplayer medieval combat. Oh. Busiest levels. Five Nights at Freddy's. Ugh. Kind of cool. Well, I played a little bit of the community. Like, that's the kind of stuff that gets made by the community. Of course, officially properly challenging levels, while the actual main game and campaign of the Little Big Planet is a good on-ramp for it. I like this whole, like, there's actually, like, dive in and stuff where it just jumps straight into the into a multiplayer game. Shall we play a little bit of multiplayer just to finish off for this video? Yeah, we might as well do that. We'll join into a game and just see if it works, it works. If it doesn't, then we'll actually just call the review at that point. Well, not a review, but kind of like the first look at Little Big Planet. Yeah, join in. No? Didn't work? Oh well. There isn't one ready going at the moment. Well, fair enough. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Have you enjoyed this? Have you enjoyed a little bit of Little Big Planet 3? There's a lot more to this game. It's free, available on PlayStation Plus for February 2017. If you haven't been playing it already, I recommend you do. If you haven't played any of the Little Big Planet games at all, you don't have to worry about it being the third in a series. It is unbelievably simple to get into and unbelievably wide in its scope of all the things that you can actually do while you're playing in it. I'd recommend giving it a try and checking it out. So yeah, if you enjoyed me talking about this game and playing a little bit of it, you can hit the subscribe button up there. And that allows you to actually see every single episode that ever comes here on the channel. Or over here on the side, you can actually just hit that and it'll be a few episodes across the top and the side of things that I've done recently here on the channel. If you enjoyed it, remember, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will see all you dudes in the next video. Bye.